At the lotus feet of our Bhagwan, dear brothers and sisters, I am happy to be back after a short trip to certain districts and address them, devotees, to build up spirits and confidence which seemed to have been lost due to the physical absence of Swami. This is the job that I have taken upon myself voluntarily. Let us see how does it take me further in this effort. I'm sorry for my absence for the last two satsangs on genuine grounds. Well, now, this week, the 11th, and next week, 18th, we'll have one on this and next week, two talks on Christmas Eve. Such as I, devotees world over, celebrate Christmas. Why not we talk about it? Why not we make some attempt to know what Christmas meant to us? Christmas is a celebration for all devotees of all religions. That is the uniqueness and the wonderful contribution of Bhagwan Sri Satyasai Baba to this world. All religions observe Christmas. Yes, a really an unbelievable phenomenon. Secondly, the Christmas celebration is not merely the one of festivity, gaiety, dancing and dinners, but Christmas celebration in Prishanthalayam, Christmas celebration by Sai devotees all over the world, meant awareness of Christmas, the depth and the significance of Christmas, and the study of the Lord Jesus as an incarnation, as an ideal man. Jesus is a diamond with so many facets of personality. 1/4 of the world are influenced by him, or even more. A boy born in a Bethlehem, after all, a hamlet, a village. Born in a shed, after all. A boy born in a manger. Could bear the torch of wisdom, could light the flame, spread wisdom to a vast humanity. The Christian mission is going on spreading day by day all over the world. It made lakhs of people to renounce the world, and they are serving Christian mission as nuns and monks. It's not an easy thing. Baba blessed me with an opportunity to visit that great city, Mexico City, Mexico, which is full of Catholic churches. How big they are, how beautiful they are, how wonderful they are. The moment we get into that church, you feel that spiritual touch. You feel that spiritual vibration. You feel the presence of Christ. You begin to feel that you are in a spiritual atmosphere. The whole city of Mexico is full of Catholic churches. I happily cherish my visit and memories for several years to come, because it's left such an impact. One of the churches in Mexico City, I saw a huge dais, raised dais, where at least 50 fathers, Catholic fathers, can sit, offer prayers. And there is a church where prayers go on all the 24 hours. Fathers work in shifts. Pope Paul John visited Mexico City thrice. They have got his statue there. I also happily recall my visit to Rio de Janeiro of Brazil. Rio de Janeiro, Brazil? I really appreciate and thank God for having made my visit possible to see that huge statue of Jesus Christ on the mountain top. Something like our Tirupati, Lord Venkateshwara on the seventh hill, so also Jesus on the seventh hill there. Of course, no temple, only one statue, 40 feet high, like that. On the mountain top, with both of his hands spread like that. Oh Lord, you are waiting for us? It is something like grandfather calling you to come close to him. I had same vibrations as I had in Shirdi, Bhagavan waiting for us. Same feeling, Bhagavan Baba waiting for us on the Christmas day. Unbelievable. So Christmas is very important to everybody. And third reason is, I was the old student of a Christian college. I'm a product of a Christian college. And I served there for 26 years. So 30 years of life in a Christian college at the prime of my youth is not a small thing. Yes. If this missionary spirit of sacrifice, if this missionary spirit of dedication and commitment, if I have in the least, the credit should go to my Christian college, my alma mater, where I studied. How fathers make speeches. Oh, what wonderful speeches they are. How they inspire people. How they interpret. Fantastic. Of late, you must be watching a kind of difference in their presentations in churches by these fathers. You'll watch them on TV. I'm very fond of a lady by name Joyce Meyer, who appears on TV addressing gathering not less than 50,000. 50,000 walking freely on a dais with huge screens on all sides, and making every presentation in a latest style. It's not fanatic, my friends. It is not dogmatic, my friends. She speaks of family relationships. She speaks of relationships that should exist between parents and children, among friends, boss and subordinates, religion applied to daily life. That's why she attracts huge audience. I never miss to watch her sermons. Not only that, religious talks by Joyce Meyer, of course I am not her official agent, Don't think that I'm getting some commission or anything like that. Nor appointed a man for propaganda or publicity. I'm sure you don't understand that way. But where people enjoy religious talks, this is very important. We go to some talks, religious talks or spiritual discourses. As we return from those talks, watch the faces of people. Longer and longer and longer. Face being elastic, head being heavy, because they speak all nonsense above our head. That has no application to our daily life. That has no relevance to our daily problems. That's why our spiritual meetings are attended by those people who have nothing else to do. What to do till the evening? We have bhajan only at 5 o'clock. What? Let us spend there, chalta hai. Because we don't have inspirational talks. We don't have motivational talks. We don't have a kind of presentation applied to our life. Situations, problems around. But I find a kind of a paradigm shift in the presentation of these Christian missionaries of late. Very, very nice, very nice. Now coming to the point, I'm sure that all of you would agree with me. A spiritual master who spoke on all topics under the sun, all topics, be that elementary school children from a village or casual labor or college students or bank directors or scientists, Baba Atomic Research Institute there, as in Trombay, Bombay, or parliamentarians, Delhi, from high elementary school level to the parliament and scientists, atomic scientists, doctors. If there is anyone who could speak to all these classes of people, of all professionals, of all countries, making them totally convinced of his authority on the subject, is only Bhagavan Sri Satsai Baba, only Bhagavan. No one else. After all, you can make preparation. I give you 1 year time, you could read books and make some presentation. We have got PowerPoint presentations also, because there is no power in our presentation, nor there is any point to speak on. Alright, so you can do it, because the PowerPoint will speak for itself and you can just go on looking at it. People will not, at least they are spared from your face and all that, at least, when they are not presentable. So my friends, you can prepare, given the time for 6 months, you can prepare, make some presentation, do it, da 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 da. But nobody will appreciate it. They need some headache pills like anacin or aspirin. But here is Satsai Baba, who made all doctors feel thrilled, excited at his knowledge, wisdom, which made these international famous doctors quote him freely in their presentations. I heard one doctor from the United States, I was there on that day. He prepared his keynote address. After listening to Swami, he kept all the keynote address on one side. PowerPoint totally packed. He noted some points that Swami spoke in his inaugural address to those doctors. He was speaking on those points and said, I gained knowledge. I have known more things. That is such a Sai Baba. That is Satya Sai Baba. And we also know how, some space scientists, astronauts, cosmonauts, when Swami gives them interview, he talks to them about the space, galaxy, lunar system, solar. A seventh class discontinued. Satya Sai Baba speaks of galaxy, lunar system, solar system. And they all begin to wonder who else can speak of this creation other than Creator Bhagavan Sri Satya Sai Baba himself. Nobody else can speak like that. Because those are the things that are not known. Swami starts speaking about them. He is wisdom personified. He is knowledge on 2 feet, full of understanding, full of awareness. And his presentations are practical. They have got relevance to our daily life. Therefore, he is most popular in the world. A few years ago, some magazines conducted a survey. Who is most popular all over the world? In their survey, they studied all God-men, gurus, including top film stars. Number one in the list, top most popular man, is Bhagavan Sri Satya Sai Baba. No spiritual guru was ever popular. Because they go on speaking do's and don'ts, better we don't go. They speak of hell and heaven, and we are not interested to know about them, because we are sure to go someday or other. Why advance our trip? Not necessary. And we don't have any first-hand description of heaven or hell. Nobody came and said, Mr. Anil Kumar, heaven is so nice, you are welcome, come. And nobody said that hell is so dangerous, fearful, frightening, please avoid it. None of the fellows came on return ticket or round trip. Nobody gave me the flight number either. So we begin to speak of that about which we do not know, about which there is no first-hand information. Baba never speaks of heaven. He never speaks of hell. He never speaks of those things above your head. Why is he popular? He makes a child from primary school and the highest scholar, greatest scholar of the times, get enchanted, captivated, thrilled, excited by his presentation. Satya Sai Baba is a world teacher for that reason. When people come and tell me, sir, this morning at 6 o'clock, I have not had even my first cup of coffee, I get a phone call, Mr. Anil Kumar Vibhuti is falling from my picture. A local person. Why don't you come and see? When Vibhuti is falling from the picture at your house, why should I come? When it is a blessing, when it is a benediction, when it is God's presence, manifestation, to be felt by you at your house, why do you tell me? I don't know. Then I got a bit irritated and said, it is something like this. Anil Kumar, please come at 11:30 lunchtime. You see as I eat. You see as I eat. I don't know, why should I see? I should also eat, you know. I should also eat, join you. I cannot simply eat and clap as you are eating. I cannot do that. Similarly, when that is falling at your residence, please enjoy yourself. Because by sharing these things, what happens is, we become egoistic.
trying to impress upon people how devoted I am.
Are there any degrees for devotion? B.A. Devotion, B.A. Devotion, M.A. Ph.D. in devotion. What?
I don't know what this publicity is.
But my friends, I'm not underestimating, please.
I'm not underestimating. I'm not denying.
I only say, don't publicize. Don't publicize.
By this publicity, we become egoistic. While the other person, oh, Swami, I have big picture at home, bigger than that. Why not Vibhuti here? What's wrong with you? Swami, are you on a holiday? Or are you irritated with me? What's wrong with you? I'll give you 1 week time. Let Vibhuti fall from the picture at my house. 1 week time, that's all. I wait. And you don't give me Vibhuti, all right. I have plenty of Vibhuti. Put it on the picture. Yes, Vibhuti is falling. This is the situation. You are making other people feel jealous of you. You concoct, manipulate, manage, create your Vibhuti on the picture of Swami. In an unhealthy rivalry, unwanted competition, making mockery of a miracle. We do not know today what a miracle is because everybody starts speaking of miracle. What should I not deny? We should not market it. We should not indulge in cheap tactics as publicity, no. But my friends, Baba is known for this. The miracle of miracles is, miracle of miracles, the greatest miracle, is silent spiritual revolution that he has brought in the contemporary society. Silent spiritual revolution. Many atheists are theists today. Many fellows who had never been to the temple throughout their life successfully till this day, they started visiting temples. People freely quote from scriptures. People think of God. Many non-vegetarians have become vegetarians. Alcoholics becoming teetotalers. Self-centered people started leading a life of and service. This kind of spiritual revolution, this sort of silent transformation among millions of people is done only by Bhagavan, Sri Satyai Baba, nobody else. Come on, take it. He does not call person after person and put his hand on the people and say, rub his head, ah, now you are changed. No, 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 no. You find some people, this Christmas, the decoration is given to devotees from Croatia. Swami had not been to Croatia. I can't show in the world map where it is. I have come to know Croatia after coming to Puttaparthi. I have not heard its name also. How is it that such a big number is here as to be in charge of decoration? How? He had not been there. He has not talked to individual people. This silent revolution, this silent transformation, this theistic tendency, theistic mentality, taking people towards the charity, kindness, consideration, is because of Bhagavan Sri Satyai Baba. That is the greatest contribution. That is the highest contribution. And above all, his messages, the divine messages. Those of us who are here don't find time to read because mind is engaged, if not the body. Why mind is engaged? I go to bhajan, not merely to attend bhajan, to see how many have come, how many have not come. Meaning I come there to maintain attendance register, policing duty. And after bhajan, we spend some time with people to collect some more gossip, some loose talk. With the result, we are so busy that with all non-essential things that we have no time to know his message or read his message. Those who are far away are busy in their own way. Think of him when he is necessary to him, when he is necessary to them. When is he necessary? If we fall sick. When is he necessary? When we are bankrupt. When is he necessary? When children revolt. When is he necessary? When we are drawn to the court. So he has become an emergency call. Emergency. Casualty ward is there in hospitals. All serious immediate cases are admitted. Our temples have become casualty wards, emergency centers. But it's not like that. God is not need-based. God is not desire-oriented. God cannot be used for selfish reasons. The faith in God should be reflected in your daily life, in your daily life, in your daily behavior, in your daily relationships, in your daily temperament and interactions, so that the whole life is spiritualized. It's not incidental, accidental, or occasional, or vacational, or professional, much less political. The whole life is spiritualized. If anybody did that, it is only Bhagavan Sri Sachai Baba. Nobody else, nobody else. You can take from me. How? He has got education program, service program, spiritual program, study circles, service every week of all sorts. He engages you such a way the lifestyle becomes spiritual totally. I am interested to project these things. I am not interested to tell you I got Swami appeared in my dream and wanted me to meet you today. Then I have to reply, Swami appeared in my dream to avoid you today. Dreams and counter dreams, why not? I cannot say that Swami appeared in my dream and wanted you to give me 1 lakh rupees, 100,000. And I would say, he appeared in my dream to collect 10 lakhs from you. Yeah, because I too can dream, why not? If the life is not a merry land, let it be dreamland at least. So it's not like that. If at all we are to speak of Baba in public, if at all we are to speak about him to our neighbors, our friends, our newcomers, let us speak on his message. Let us speak on his philosophy. And if we are still interested in these individual experiences, let us do it with a message behind it. Miracles don't just happen. It has got a message. Take for example, Jesus restored sight to blind people. Jesus brought back to life the dead ones. What is the message there? The message is the expression of divinity. There is nothing that is impossible to divine. That is the message behind it. Not that blind man to say, I got the light, I got the sight, so Swami, please take it back because he is bothering me too much. Please take away that. So that he'll sit silent. He has become too noisy by your grace in the form of miracles. Miracles should not make me or you noisy. Miracle should not make us proud or egoistic. A miracle should make us more humble, more simple, more serviceable, more knowledgeable, more of awareness, more of kindness, more of nearness, dearness to devotees, more of constant integrated awareness. CIA. That's what it is, my friends. You may take me as a crazy man. I don't mind. I want to be still more crazy. Because as I feel the contemporary society, as I see what people expect from us, their spiritual needs, their spiritual demands, I am afraid that we have not realized and understood, because our presentations they run parallel to the contemporary expectations. Suppose I talk to my students there, I speak of Atma, Paramatma, Parabrahman. Boys are helpless, what to do? Because there's free education and marks are in my hands. So, and they have learned the technique also today. I don't know, some of us may have technique, that also. What is the technique? To sleep with the eyes open. Yes. The, I think it's more than the samadhi state of rishis. We see, we find every rishi saying closing the eyes, attaining state of samadhi. But some of our devotees and most of our students are more than rishis because they can sleep with the eyes open. Nirvikalpa samadhi. It's not that, my friends. What the students need, I should tell them Baba's message to the youth of this country. I should tell him his expectations from students. Sai ideals, Sai students, Sai teachers, Sai goals, Sai aspirations, Sai way of life. I should speak on those topics, not on Brahman, Paramatman, neither. We should do that. There one drama was enacted here in Sai Kulandhal. Small children, primary school, gave a presentation. A boy, maybe 10 years old or so. What is there in samsara? What is there in a family? Who are brothers, who are sisters? That fellow doesn't know the spelling of brother and sister. What nonsense it is. Religion is to be natural. Spirit, to be spiritual is to be natural. To be spontaneous is religious. To be relaxed is religion. To enjoy life is religion. To make everybody happy, laugh, is religion. To release tension, stress, is religion. Not to add extra burden of spiritual dosage is already medicated by life. Why extra MG of spirituality? Why not necessary? Such as Sai Baba is very, very successful in his lifetime. To make the life really enjoyable, in Prashanthi Nilayam, you don't know the date and day. You don't know the date and day. We should inquire, is it today or Monday? Monday or Tuesday? Must be someday, don't worry. What is time? 3 o'clock or 4 o'clock? Six? Six? Yes? Oh, I thought it is four, okay. So, he was very successful, Baba, in taking us beyond time and space. Nobody could do that. You try at the bus stand and railway station. You try there. You feel like beating those fellows. you are highly irritated in spite of 3 cups of tea, because you have to wait for 4 hours. Here, how are you able to spend like that? That is charisma, charisma, magnetic effect of Bhagavan Sri Satya Sai Baba. To outgrow the limitations of day and date and time. We are not, because he engages our attention throughout day in a very, very funny way. And we have that immediately something from him at every crucial point of our life. When we suffer from heavy loss, immediately we get Swami's message from within. Don't worry, they are like passing clouds. They are like passing clouds. No cloud is permanent. After all, life, this happiness is an interval between two pains. That's all. Some message from within. You don't need any upadesha to get up at 4 o'clock to do some penance or get up in the midnight. Not necessary. When you have a problem, you get an answer within. That is Bhagavan Sri Satya Sai Baba. When you feel so proud of your achievements and something like that, immediately you get a message from within. Zero has no value without one by its side. With that one zero has value, any number of zeros will have value. If the one number is there, that one is hero God, you're all zeros. Don't feel proud of yourself. Then you calm down. Landing time. Or else crash landing. Find our names in the newspapers on the title sheet. So whenever there is something like that, when I feel this is all, I'm that, that's all. This is my group, this is my plot, this is my land. Someone was telling me, he's just 83 years young. A few days ago, he sits there. He was telling me, this place is allotted to me, so I sit here every day. Very good, sir. Before you started coming here, this place must have been allotted to somebody else. We do not know. And after us, there will be many people who will occupy this. Alright, we have come here to find a place in the heart of Sai, not on slabs and stones. That is the situation. Then immediately we get a message from within. Arey boy, are you fool or what? Did I not tell you that religion is a travel from I to we? So long it is I, it's not religion, I, pity it is. You have that feeling of we-ness, community. We, that's religion. And when you want to criticize those people, what is it? There are some people. Do you attend Nagar Sankirtan? No, sir. You don't ever? So what? So what? I attend. So attend. You attend? I never say no to you. Why are you bothered about my attendance? Meaning? Gone up. So when we feel like expressing like that, then comes a message from within. Seek out your own faults and others' merits. Find out your own mistakes and others' merits. That is called from Bhagavan. How practical they are! How wonderful they are! Each one is a diamond, which are useful to the life situations at this moment, at this hour, for this problem, for this situation. Yes. Therefore Bhagavan Sri Satya Sai Baba could attract the whole world. It is in this context I wanted to speak on Jesus the Lord as a personality and certain principles that he emphasized, connecting with the life and message of Bhagavan Sri Satya Baba. I'm always interested in comparative study. I'm always interested in this process of synthesis, congregation worship, unity of faiths, for which Bhagavan is the only champion, take it from me. He is the only champion who stood for unity of religions. Unity of faiths, no one. No one. One fellow came and said, "I want to change my name, Swami." "Oh, I see. How do you want to change?" "Satya Sai." "Don't change your name. Be Sai. What is in the name? You be Sai, not the name of a Sai. It's not that important. It's not that important." Somebody came and said, "I wear walker robes. Same dress as Swami." Some people come there, red gown and all that, with hair and all that. Life is not a drama company. By wearing the dress, you cannot be Satya Sai Baba. Impossible. By having that hair, you cannot be Satya Sai Baba. I know one friend, I know him very well. He comes here, has got the hairstyle of Abdul Kalam. Same Abdul Kalam. Same style. You see him, I see him. He's from one of the neighboring districts. The hair parted center, long hair. Really? I go and tell him, "You are not Abdul Kalam, you are Abdul Ghulam." Impossible. Appearances are deceptive. We also find one fellow dressed like Mahatma Gandhi, very lean with a shirt. We think, watch him and all. Of course, he is white Gandhi, white paint all over the world. So people started staring. What to do? All of them is Chandra Kumar Gandhi, Gandhi, Gandhi. Then I called all those fellows. Gandhi never stood like that at the crossroads. He never spread his towel to collect coins like that. He is a beggar Gandhi. He is not Mahatma Gandhi. He is Gandhi, but he is BG, beggar Gandhi. So by imitating, we don't get anything. We don't get anything. By imitating, when I want to imitate you, immediately Swami tells me within, imitation is human, creation is divine. Imitation is human, creation is divine. These thoughts come automatically. Something like as they appear on the screen of a computer. Whenever there is some sidetracking in our behavior, whenever there is some trespassing, immediately you get a message from within. Therefore, somebody asked, "If I wear dress, how does it look? Wear Swami's dress." Then the tailor said, "You can have that color." Then Swami, known for humor, he said, "If you wear the dress of a woman, you cannot be a woman." Right? By wearing the dress of a woman, you cannot be a woman. Impossible. It's only dramatization. So there's nothing great about these appearances or dresses or makeup. No. It's only our nature, spontaneity, that natural quality, that commitment that matter. Therefore, there are certain very, very famous quotes from the Holy Bible. The Holy Bible says, see that, "Blessed are the poor." Blessed are the poor. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. For they shall see God. How am I to know that I have pure heart? Many people speak of pure heart being themselves sufficiently impure. Those that speak about pure heart are mostly impure. Please take it from me. Because they don't, because a pure heart cannot see impure heart. See? So what is a pure heart? Blessed are pure in heart, for they shall see God. What is it? Is the heart pure or impure? No heart specialist can say that. Heart specialist cannot decide whether your heart is pure or impure. He will only see if you have heart attack or not.
Desireless. Desireless. That does not desire anything. Why? Because a pure heart is the one of surrender. Oh God, you do it in the way you want. Oh God, I accept. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Let your will prevail. I have no option. I have no preference. I have no choice. Let you decide and take the life in the way you want. I allow. And this is surrender. So, quality of a pure heart is desirelessness and the spirit of acceptance or surrender to God's will. What is a pure heart then? What else? Because we say, all people say pure heart, stop nonsense. Tell me what pure heart is. Not that beats, something more than that. What is a pure heart again? Pure heart is that prays for the welfare of the world. That prays for the welfare of the world. Lokas samastas sukhino bhavantu. Sarve janas sukhino bhavantu. Let all the worlds be happy. Let all people be happy. A pure heart, an impure heart, let me be only happy. Let me be only rich. That is highly polluted, dirty, useless heart. Better it stops functioning for the betterment of the society. Useless heart, right? So a pure heart makes you pray for the world. That's what Baba says. A pure heart will prompt a feeling within you to help people around you. To help people around you. Pure heart. Help? They're all like, what sort of help should I do? Don't make them unhappy by your talk. Don't bore them by your worldly talk or self-glorification. At least if you make them happy by your talk, if you make them smile by your talk, yes, there is a help. We think help meant cleaning the roads, washing the temples. So, one man brought me a tabular form, Sevadal Kanina. Serial number, name of the activity, total number of people benefited. I can, yes, 50 benefited. Polio can, 150 benefited. Narayan Seva, 500 people fitted. Cremation ground cleaned. Burial ground cleaned. I said, how many are benefited? How many are benefited by cleaning? Cemetery. It's not this. So let not go by numbers, or let not go by the number of activities, my friends. Let go by the spirit behind. To make other person happy is the greatest service.
or at least not to make others, is also service. Not to make others unhappy is also service. Because there are some people you meet. You know, last week my blood pressure was, 3 days back, my blood pressure was, and today my BP is, in the process my BP will shoot up. So this fellow did greatest of service to me, to go to the doctor immediately. So at least, not to make others happy, preferably to make others smile and happy, is a great service. Now Baba says, a pure heart will bring a glow on our face, a glow, a kind of radiance, a kind of brilliance, a sort of magnetic attraction. Yes. Because it is like, the face will have sunshine of joy wherever they go. Sunshine of joy wherever they go. Pure heart. When the heart is impure, people will avoid us. Some people ask me, why not they talk to me? I say, because you are like that. They don't talk to you because you are like that. It means a total change in you. Don't blame anybody. Therefore, my friends, to spread sunshine of joy, to have a joyful glow on our face, is an expression, indication of a pure heart. Blessed are those with pure heart, for they shall see God. For they shall see God. That's what the Holy Bible says. And what should be our prayer? What should be our prayer? Swami, that land seems to be very costly. And please allow me to grab some land there. And there are some chances of coming up in life. Please help me. Please help me to please the boss, to have unlawful promotions. It's not that. Oh, let me have at least 5 houses in Bombay. Only 5, not more than that. Or let me buy Connaught Place in Delhi. Why not? So, let's not ask for money. Let's not ask for positions. What should be our prayer? Oh God, the Holy Bible says, lead me to thyself. Lead me to thyself. Oh. Very easy. Lead me to thyself. There are 2 ends here. One word, creation. The other, creator. Are you going to choose the creation or the creator? You want some gold jewels or gold mine? Gold mine. Gold mine is the creator. Gold jewels. Jewels are, constitute a creation. Therefore, lead me, meaning in preference to the world. In preference to the worldly, sensual, momentary pleasure. Let me pray, O God, lead me to thyself. Lead me towards you. Lead me towards your thought. Lead me towards your service. Lead me towards your contemplation. Lead me to your meditation. Lead me to that paradise. Lead me to that state as to sing your glory continuously. Satatam yoginaha sarvatra sarvakaleshu sarvada hari chintanam. Sarvatra, everywhere. Sarvakaleshu, all the time. Sarvada, every moment. Hari chintanam, sing the glory of God. Lead me to thyself. That should be our prayer. How should I pray, God? How should I pray? Shall I announce you? Tomorrow at 7 o'clock I'm going to pray. I see. So till 6 you are not praying. And all these days you are not praying. Because you are announcing tomorrow 7 o'clock. Nonsense. The Holy Bible says, Baba refers to this point. Close the door and pray. Close the door and pray. For the Father who is secret heareth in secret. For the Father who is in secret heareth in secret. Meaning, don't misunderstand me, my friends. A spiritual life is different from a spiritual appearance. Agreed? I may have vibhuti from that corner of the Kasturi had such vibhuti on his forehead. Baba said, "Are vibhuti is looking like bandage. You don't have to bandage." As he had some plaster over there. So, these are the marks that would bring the attention of the public to say, is a devotee one, number one, you know, he wears such a rudraksha of that size. Is he dhyatara or what? Or mantrik or tantrik? Not necessarily. Where are we? What is happening? In what direction we are going? I don't know. There is no other joke other than one's own life. There is no other greater comedy than one's own life. There is nothing to laugh at more than one's own life. That's all. I can just laugh myself. What is happening to me? Therefore, close the door, meaning you can pray yourself within yourself. You can be prayerful, you can be respectful, not to give appearance like that. It is said, somebody said, I constructed that hostel, you know. Oh, I see. Oh, that hostel bears my name. Oh, good. And this man goes to heaven. And those heaven fellows said, sorry, you're out. This is not your place. Go to heaven. And what is this transfer? Why? Those fellows in charge of heaven said, because of the hostel you constructed, we brought you here. But seeing the record, you are not worthy here. You have no birth here. Why? Because you have named that hostel after you. It is your name. Shastri name or Reddy name or something. You have got your name. So people recognize you. So you got your benefits there. Here, place is hell, not heaven. You named your actions of charity after yourself. Then you got publicity. So you have no place in paradise. Therefore, do it silently. How Baba helps people, you know that? I know. So once he asked me, put some 10 lakhs something on the check. I was counting. He said, what kind of process are you? Can't you put 10 lakhs? How many zeros do you have? Don't you know that? Don't you know the number of zeros for 10 lakhs? And you are a professor. But I am not upset for Swami Sinmar. I am bothered about other fellows in the interview room. They too may put a similar question outside, what kind of teacher are you? Then I immediately said, Swami, I am just a teacher. I never saw 10 lakhs any time. I never gave checks to 10 lakhs. My checks are only 100, I'm sorry. So how am I to know 10 lakhs, number of zeros? Therefore it takes time for me. But those rich business people at that level cross, shut up. I cannot do it. My level is only 100, sir. How? Then he laughed and what a knack. Come on, put Swami. The point is that check is silently given to a boy to seek admission to a medical college. Silently kept it in pocket. 10 lakhs. Whereas you and I don't put silent labor. If we offer a cup of coffee today, we expect that fellow to say thank you until he dies or until, or until I leave or he leaves the planet. Baba is non-expectational. Silent. Some poor people, religious came here, Swami, how what? We have consecrated temple. How far has it come? Swami, it has come up to that level, Swami's level. Oh. All are participating? Yes, Swami, all are participating, I see. What is the rough estimate of the building? Swami, about 20 lakhs. But a boy can immediately give it. Come on, do it. Nobody knows. When God does it silently, man wants to do it publicly. When God does many, man does little. When God does selflessly, man expects name and fame. When God does it as duty, man does it as a favor. That is the difference. That's why we are not able to experience God in spite of our fabulous amounts of donation and acts of charity. Therefore, close the door and pray that the spirit behind it. And then, some people, we are all of us are disturbed with the disturbances. Any simple thing will disturb us. Any simple thing. Any simple, like what? When I don't find my paper on the table, I'm highly disturbed. I go on searching for it. I have a number of other papers I can use it. No, that last paper is more important than the paper. When spoon is not found, there are 10 spoons. No, that spoon which is lost. We get disturbed for everything. Even one person doesn't say Sai Ram, we go, why did he not say that? Or is there anybody who told against me to that man? Or is he trying to take me away from my place? Or is he scandalizing me outside? Ayyayo, that fellow is busy with his own problems. He is thinking of his BP and sugar. So again he says Sai Ram because he is ready to meet Sai Ram. We get disturbed, really. We need not be disturbed like that. So, here the Bible says, to bear and endure. To bear and endure is ever a mark of him who would grow in the glory of God. Who would grow in the glory of God to bear and endure? That's what Saburi meant. That's what Siddha meant. We should be able to bear and endure. Yes. Why? To grow in the glory of God. Therefore, my friends, this capacity of endurance, this capacity to bear with all the problems of life and the people around and negative forces will help us to grow in the glory of God. And another point, clearly the Bible says, your love for God should be in your priority. Anything next, priority. That's what Baba always says. J-O-Y, joy, What does it mean? Joy. You get the joy when you give preference to others. Therefore, first God, others next, and you come in the last. Jesus first. Others next. Why you in the last? Why? Jesus, others, you. Who said it other than Baba? Nobody can say that. Nobody can say that. Nobody can give an interpretation of that kind. So when you keep Baba first, others next, yourself in the last, that is a spiritual life. Before, I know it's time up, but before taking leave from you, let me say this. What is a paradise? Where is it? Yes, man has gone into the fathomless depths, into the ocean. Man has climbed the mountains. He climbed the peak, mountain peak Everest. He could have all kinds of flights today. Jet fighters, bombers, go at any height, at terrific speed. Where is paradise? They have not noticed any paradise. You ask any pilot, you go around the world, where is paradise? He says, I don't know where paradise is, but you should be in a mental hospital. Where is paradise? Baba clearly says, a paradise is that. Where? And when you give up your I-ness. A moment when you give up your I-ness, when the moment is given up, got rid of, dispensed with, that is paradise. That is the very heaven, Baba says. And then the Holy Bible says another thing in answer to a question. What is the noblest thing? What is the purest thing? What is best of all? Noblest, purest, best of all. What is it? Going on a pilgrimage? Or fasting? Or observe vigil throughout night? What is the purest, noblest and the best? That is, love and longing for God. Love and longing for God is the purest, noblest and the best. What is love? What is longing? I love Him, but I may not long. I may be longing, I may not be loving. Simple. I'm waiting for my boss. I'm longing, but I have no love for Him. You may love, but you may not love. Supposing some of the relatives, you love them, but you don't long because you have to cook at home, extra work. And the house on, you cannot accommodate guests. So there may be love without longing, there may be longing without love. But when there's love and longing together for God, it is the noblest, purest, and the best, says the Holy Bible. Baba gives the meaning of Jesus Christ in His own way. No parallel. Once I was talking to Swami and said, Swami, nobody said like this. Just I said it. Nobody spoke like this, Swami. You know, His reply. Is there anyone who knows these things? Is there anyone who knows these things to tell you? So, there's no chance for you to know from anybody. No chance for you to know from anybody because no one knows these things. Therefore, Baba is unique, special in His own way, in every respect. What does he say about Christ? He doesn't speak of Christ as a personality. He doesn't refer to Christ as a human being. He doesn't refer to Christ as a man, as a normal man. No. He says, Christ represents Ananda principle, the blissful state, the blissful state, not a state of happiness, not a state of joyfulness. It's not an ordinary, mundane, physical, worldly level of experience. It is a blissful, non-dual spiritual experience. That is the meaning of Jesus Christ. That's what implication in his name. So Swami, okay, said, what shall I do? What shall I do now? Christ represents Ananda, bliss. So what? How does he help me? Therefore our duty is meditate on him, on his love. Meditate on him, meditate on his love. This will help us to meditate on Bhagavan Sri Satsai Baba, to love him more and more. This is what is meant by imitation of Christ.